What's going on, YouTube? Sam's here with TKO Gaming. We're here at the Leviathan Raid. This is one of many guides for this raid. It's the best guides that we came up with that is going to help you get this raid done easily with your friends and family. Now, what you want to do is two things. Number one, if you want Destiny 2 Silver, make sure you like this video, comment down below. That's all you have to do. Make sure you're a subscriber because you will be directly DM'd, and the winner can choose for what console they want their silver for, so you can get those bright engrams and exotics and everything. Number two, if you need help with the raid, trials, or any quests, we guarantee help. All you have to do is read the description below and get in touch with us. So let me explain exactly what's going on. You have four different platforms and you have four different chains. Do not count the middle room. The middle room is kind of like a hybrid. So essentially what you want to do is you want to think back to the King's Fall in those totem phase where you had three people on each side. It's almost the same exact thing. So you have these big dudes with swords coming. You have to kill those big dudes with swords. And what you want to do is you want to go to the middle, redo your times 50 psionic protection, whatever the hell it's called. Once you have that protection, which it really doesn't protect you from shit, actually it does. What it is the water, it damages you unless you have that protection. So to be able to stand on the platform, you need to have that times 50. So, or you don't need to have times 50, but you need to have times something of that psionic protection. Now also keep in mind, you only get one res, so you do not want to mess up. Because once you res somebody, you can't pick that person up again. Pretty interesting, because then you have to send people from different sides. So essentially you want to have three people on each side. You want to be on a platform. The guy in the middle picks up a fresh times 50. Then he'll come. That's the only place you can just recharge your times 50 over and over again, is the middle. So you pick it up, then you go over to one person's platform. That person from that platform that was already there then goes to the middle to recharge times 50, then goes to the other side of the platform. Now remember, if you have three and three divided, let's say you're on one side, you will always stay on that one side. So then when your chains go all the way up, then what you want to do is you want to go to the middle, because you'll have times 50 fresh, and that's all you have, that times 50, and you have to shoot these lamps. There's 3, 3, 3, so there's 9 total lamps. What you want to do is, essentially what we did was we had 4 people on DPS and 2 people on killing adds, and then really if I had my super and everything, I was the only one killing adds, because the Arc Warlock is just OP as hell. I had a healing rift here with the Arc Soul. It helped a ton. My team was getting their, you know, overshield for protection, plus a little Arc Soul buddy to then shoot pretty much anything. And then that's pretty much rinse and repeat is what you have to do. You can do it in two phases. What we did is you want to get at least 5 lights in the first phase, and then the second phase is a breeze. Now you have those little sword guys coming when it's the damage phase. But remember, guys, you want to make sure everybody goes into the damage phase. Now, once you get off your platform, like right now, if you see, you know, I picked it up from the middle. Now I'm going back over to my teammate. I'm going to hop on his platform and he's going to go to the middle. If we had any more of a delay, like if he hopped off his platform and then I didn't make it onto his platform, then that way the chain would start reversing. So your effort or your progress would then be in reversal. So you want to make sure you keep those things in mind. What weapons I would recommend is a sword. Those big sword guys, if you have a sword, a legendary sword, it actually, the right trigger powerful attack, it's like 3 of those and they'll kill them. And I'm a low light, so it's 2 of them. If you're a high light, like if you're like a 300 light or whatever, it's just 2 swipes and they're dead. And so essentially, once you have that, you want to make sure you're utilizing your supers and your grenades. Pulse grenades are really, really helpful if you guys see exactly the way I'm killing the sword guys. And that's about it, man. Just rinse and repeat. You're going to get it done and you're going to get loot. For the loot, what you're going to get, and you'll see in this video, you'll get coins. You're not going to get like the actual gear how we did in Destiny 1. You'll get coins, and I'm guessing there's going to be a vendor or something that you can go forth and then get your raid loot from. But I hope this video helped you guys out. If it did, please do drop a like. It helps a ton. Subscribe if you haven't. I am going to be doing a console giveaway at 75,000 subscribers, which is a milestone for me. And then 100,000 is going to be an even bigger giveaway. So thank you guys so much for being a part of this Destiny 2 community. You can also be a part of the stream community, twitch.tv/realtkogaming. The link is in the description below. We're on every social media you can imagine. Everything is at RealTKO Gaming. My weapon setup is a Risk Runner, which is really good, a sword, and my primary is like a really powerful pulse rifle. Actually, no, this is a scout rifle that I'm using. Really, any weapon that you like, you should use. I do not recommend snipers, at least for this part of the raid. Snipers need a buff. They're not doing very well. So essentially, you'll see in the second phase, we're here. We're going to be killing everything else, and I really hope you guys enjoyed the short rest of the video, and you guys get to see our loot. There's going to be pretty much every phase. I'm going to put out the best tutorial guide, and it would mean a lot to me if you guys would share it and help the rest of the community out to possibly get them to understand what's going on in this raid. It's a beautiful raid. Good job, Bungie. We'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out. Beep.